Lawrence, 14 league games into your Swansea career. How pleased are you with the way things are going?
I think it's been good, been tough, but it's nothing that I didn't expect. Really enjoyed it. Just hopefully it can continue.
You seem to have settled in very easily.
I think it's not just, you know, it's everyone, I think, that's helped me settle down. I think, from the staff to the players and everyone, they've really helped me every day to day with things off the pitch as well as on the pitch. And, you know, I think that makes it easy when everything at home's going well. And then, you know, you come into training and you can give your all. So it's been good.
You've never played in the Championship before, have you, this season? Do you feel like you've proved to yourself that you can do it?
Yeah, I think, I always thought I could play at this level. It's obviously been very, very tough to get a long road to get here. And, you know, I'm just enjoying every day because, you know, it's taken me a very, very long time to get to this level. And, you know, as long as I can just enjoy it and just keep training and working hard every day, then, you know, hopefully the performances on the Saturday can be good as well.
For a goalkeeper, is it different from an outfield player in terms of making the step up? How noticeable is it?
It's difficult. I think a lot of it is mentally as well. I think, you're playing against really, really good players week in, week out, international players and stuff. So it can be really, really tough. But, you know, I think for me, I just take each game as it comes. I think, the staff here, they give me so much detail with everything I do to help me. And I think it's helped so far this season.
And defensive record for the team has obviously been a vital part of the success you've had so far. So that's, as a goalkeeper, that's going to make you happy.
Yeah, of course. I think, we have such good defenders here. They work so hard every day in training. We all as a group work really hard as well. And I think that's really important for everybody because, it's not just the defenders, it's not just me, it's not just, it's everyone working together as a collective to have such a good defensive record at the moment. And, I think we can be really proud of it so far.
And as a unit, obviously, as you say, the whole team are involved, but the defensive unit, yourself, the two centre-backs who've played every minute, Josh Tymon and Josh Key, for the most part, have been playing at full-back, haven't they? You've all had a pretty good start, haven't you?
Yeah. I think, I think that's just mainly down to how hard we work day-to-day on the training pitch, the manager, all the staff. Know what they give us day to day, the detail. I think I think that helps initially, and then we also have to have the hunger to defend. And I think, like I said before, it's not just the back four and me, and it's everybody. I think you look at people like Miles and Flo when he come on Tuesday, how hard he worked for the team. I think and the crowd appreciates that, and we completely 100% appreciate everything that they do up there, because if we can stop it at source up there, then we don't have to do as much work. So really enjoy that.
Yeah. Last weekend, you broke the run without a win, didn't you? You look pretty happy on Instagram afterwards, Lawrence. I think you, obviously, your Swindon connections, you got a little stick, did you?
Yeah, I think because I got sent off there twice. So I got sent off in both games in the league. So they give me a bit of stick every time I go there. But no, it was good. I think more important than what was happening, like with them booing me and stuff, was that we won the game and we scored a goal, which was, what we've been working so hard towards. And I was so happy for VP to score because, he works so hard every day. He scores so many goals in training. And, I'm waiting for him to just, get a few more goals here and he'll be up and running, because he deserves it. As a guy, he's a wonderful guy. And, and then Flo as well, to come on and score that was brilliant. At such a crucial time of the game where, they are pushing, to try and get an equaliser, he just, kind of gives us that two-goal cushion, and, we were fortunate enough to see it out at the end.
What were your red cards for at Oxford?
I got two yellows there. We lost 2-0, I think it was.
For fouls or time wasting? Or?
I got one. I'm not going to repeat what I said to the lino, but I said something to the lino. he gave me a yellow, and then, it was a tackle, and I got up. I was a bit angry at the guy, what he'd done, like tried to tackle me, and I kind of pushed him, and I got another yellow. And then the home one was last man. It wasn't even me, but the ref, they were all saying it was me, and he sent me off, but we appealed it and it got rescinded. So That's what people don't ever see. They just think I got sent off twice.
Nice to stay on the pitch though last weekend, I imagine, till the end.
Yeah, yeah. I was just thinking to myself, if they go through 1-1, I'm not going out because I can't get sent off again. Yes, it was a really good performance, and you know, I'm so happy that we got 3 points.
As a team, what do you feel like you can achieve this season?
You know, I think for us, you know, we just got to keep it game by game. You know, we work so hard again. Like I say, you know, we just mentally we are in a really, really good place. We've had two really tough games, tough opponents to play against, and you know, I think, you know, we just got to keep it going day to day and working hard and doing what we can do, doing what we do best to try and get 3 points on the weekend.
Yeah, you mentioned the weekend, a trip to Burnley. How do you look forward to going back there?
Yeah, I think I'm looking forward to going there. I don't think I'll get any boos because, you know, I think unless he was watching the warm-up, you wouldn't know who I am. So, I think it'll be a tough game. You know, they've just come down from the Premier League. I know a lot of them, and you know, I know the manager as well. And I know that it will be a really, really tough game. They've got really, really good individuals, a lot of quality. And, you know, I think if we can go there, you know, we play the way we have the last two games. You know, football is, you know, you never know what happens, you know, and I'm really looking forward to playing there.
And you look back on your time there positively, don't you? Even though, as you say, you never got the chance to play in the first team, did you?
Yeah, of course. You know, I think it was a really, really good learning curve for me. You know, learning under a manager that has ended up going to Bayern Munich and all his staff. So, you know, for me, it was really, really good to you know get my eye in at that sort of level. And you know, I really enjoyed my time there in terms of, you know, with the players and, you know, the day-to-day stuff in the changing room. And, you know, I really enjoyed that part of it. Of course, it was a bit frustrating not playing. And, you know, I think that's why I made the decision that I wanted to go at the end of the season. And, you know, I think I'm really, really happy with the decision that I've made.
And you're back, if I can just ask you about international football, you're back involved with Chile. How have you found that in the last couple of months?
Yeah, it's been, you know, a bit frustrating in terms of the results. I think, you know, we've played some really, really good teams. But, you know, we're at a point now where we've got two really important games after the game on Sunday, which, you know, I think we need to get a few wins. So, but, you know, I don't really think about it at the moment. You know, I just think that, you know, once the game on Sunday is done, then, you know, when I land in Chile on Monday or Tuesday, that, you know, I'm ready to work for them. And then, you know, as soon as the games are done, I'm back and I'm ready to, you know, attack the rest of the week before we play Leeds. So, you know, it'll be really important, you know, for the country as well. They're crazy for football. So, you know, you just want to make them proud. But, you know, first and foremost, we have a big game on Sunday. That's at the forefront of my mind.
Yeah. Just on Chile, though, you've not got a senior cap yet, is that right? Yeah. But the coach changed the goalkeeper, am I right in saying, in the last window? I mean, did you think you might have had a chance, or how do you feel like you're close to getting in the side?
Yeah, you know, at the end of the day, I think it depends on what the manager wants. I've just got to keep doing what I'm doing here, working, like, you know, my distribution and stuff and making saves and trying to help the team out with crosses and stuff. And, you know, if that allows me to get a senior cap, then it does. But, you know, first and foremost, I play for Swansea, you know, so, you know, my first thing on my mind is can I help the boys here? And then if anything happens and comes of it, it will. But, you know, that's not what I'm really thinking of right now.
Does the coach watch Swansea's games, as far as you know?
Yeah, the goalkeeper coach, yeah, he does, yeah. He watches every game and then he'll send me, like, a debrief of what he thought. And it's, you know, it's good to have that, you know, someone that cares and someone that watches, you know, all your games and stuff. So I'm happy that they watch it and they take an interest. But, you know, at the end of the day, you know, for me personally, I think what the manager here and what Marge say, I think is what I need to be listening to day to day, because, you know, they're the ones that allow me to have the opportunity to play for this club.
Does the travel, obviously it's not a short journey, is it, for you in every international break? Has that been a challenge for you, or do you cope with it easily?
It's very difficult. You know, I think in terms of the turnaround of when we get back to when we play, but I can't really complain because, you know, I think there was a guy at Norwich that we played Norwich on the Saturday, and there was a guy from Chile as well. that plays for him, and we were just talking for the whole week about, oh, I can't wait to play each other and that on the Saturday, and ended up playing, and he ended up playing the first game and then got suspended for the second Chile game, and then he was back in England like on the Monday and I got back on Thursday, so it was like he wasn't jet lagged at all and I was a bit, but I think when you come back from time zone, I think it's easier to adapt. So I'm lucky. I'm not like Nathan, who's coming back from 9 hours ahead. I think that's a lot more difficult, or Jason, for example. So I think, I'm just lucky that it's there. I think it's only 3 hours behind, so it'll be a bit easier.